Today's a big day, off to Chamonix to go and race the CCC on Friday. It's Wednesday, it's 20 to 10, so I'm just going to do a quick vlog on the kit I am taking. You get a very comprehensive road book. It's about 30 pages in total, but you pick out the bit about the CCC because obviously there's other races at UTMB week. And on it has a pretty comprehensive list of the compulsory items. So I'm going to go through them. And there's some other stuff I will take as well, so I'll add that to my list. So let's check it out. Right, bag. They want you to take a bag. Obviously, you're going to take a bag, so you've got to take kit. I'm running with my new Innovate Pro 2 bag. I've chosen this because I can run with it in the UK without this part, so you can take this off. And I've done quite a bit of online research, and this can be removed, so yeah, during the day I can just run normally with a couple of bottles. But for the CCC, I'm going to take the whole caboodle. The next item you need is water bottles, a minimum of 1 litre, so those are what I'm going to take, and they'll slip nicely inside my bag. Right, in the bag, what else do you need? You've got to take a cup. They call it a tumbler, so I'm going to take that. You can also take a bowl if you want. They serve noodle soup, things like that. I may just pour that in there. It gets a bit messy, a bit gross, but don't really care. Going to take a little fork with me as well, a little spork. So if they do have something to eat, I'll try and use that. And what else? Lights, really important. Got to take 2 lamps. First one I'm taking is my Petzl Neo. And you need 2 batteries. These are heavy batteries. The downside of this, it's a brilliant torch. The downside is the batteries are super heavy, so you've got to take 2 of those. So they're charged, fully charged. There's my lamp, which I'll wear from basically, I reckon it's going to be finishing about 3-4 in the morning. So I'm going to have, what's that, sort of eight hours of darkness-ish, depending what time it gets dark and the weather. So yeah, that's good. And then you need another lamp as well. I take this little Petzl one, mini one, get you out of trouble, and you need batteries for that. So I need to go and get some batteries for that. Right, survival blanket, as always. The size of the survival blanket is 2 by 1.4. This is a 1.3 by 2.1. That will do, survival blanket. You need ID. Because we're going over 3 different countries, crossing the starting in Italy, Courmayeur, and then going over to Champagne-Lac, which is in Switzerland, and then finishing in France in Chamonix. Cool, huh? 3 countries. So you need some ID. I'll be taking my passport. You need to take a mobile phone as well, fully charged mobile phone. On this, they recommend you have an app. It's called, I'm getting this right, Live Run. Really good. And I'm tracking my friends at the moment. They're doing the TDS, so shout out to them. Good luck, guys. Mateus, Matt, and Alessio, good luck. TDS, how far have they gone? Geez, they've been going for 3 hours 33 so far. And then that there will give you all the data of where you are. So I'm going to use that, be fully charged, and it's a new phone, so it's got really good battery life. I will switch it to low battery. I'm also going to take a few pics with that as well. So you've got to have your mobile phone. They recommend that you take some bandage. I'm not sure what size. Yeah, adhesive elastic tape for bandaging or strapping. 1 meter by 6 centimeters. Well, I will take my actual first aid kit. So I'll have that with me. And I will also take some tape, which is that. So that will go in there like that. So that's your first aid kit. That's compulsory items. What else we got? We've got mobile phone, we've done whistle. The whistle's on the bag. So you've got a little whistle here. And where is it? Little whistle there. Not really very good, but I think that'll get you out of trouble. There'll be people around. And so we've done the water, headlamps. That's your compulsory items you need. Then you've got clothing. Okay? So clothing. They want you to take the jacket with a hood. Okay, this is an Om jacket I've had for years. Is it waterproof? It's okay. But really, I haven't found a waterproof jacket. I mean, if anyone knows a decent waterproof jacket to get, I hear Gore are really good, but they're very expensive, but probably is the one. But unfortunately, you're going to be sweating a lot, and you're going to get wet. So this has got a 10,000 mil rating. 10,000 mil, what that means is it can receive 10 meters of water. I don't know, I've looked it up. Put a comment in there if you know more about it. But anyway, there's my jacket with a hood, really important. They also want you to take a layer, an additional warm layer. So I'll just take my Helly Hansen top. I haven't upgraded all this stuff, it's so expensive. But you can get really nice merino wool ones, which I'm up for buying at some point. But there's my top, that'll keep me warm. Then, very importantly, the weather will change out there. Last year, it was terrible in the evening, at night. I think you go up to 2,400 meters of elevation. The weather changes, just you just don't know. And the weather forecast is not looking good. There's a lot of rain. Oh, there's thunder, and it's just black clouds. Hopefully, it will improve, but I think it's going to be slightly wet. You've got to take your basically waterproof trousers, which I've got, and also a pair of tights, running tights. These are skin ones, just a pair of running tights. That'll keep you warm. Also, gloves. Really, really important, which if you've seen my vlog of Snowdon, you'll know that I went and actually invested in a decent pair. These are waterproof. They're probably about 30 quid, 40 quid gloves, but they're brilliant, and they'll keep my hands really warm and really dry, and those are essential. You can buy like cheaper thin ones, but they're useless. They just get wet and you just get cold hands, so I really recommend those. Nice pair of waterproof gloves. Downside, they are quite big. Right, what's next? They also want you to take a cap. So I will be running with my Destination Unknown cap, of course, that one there, and a buff. So I always take two. I put one on the wrist to wipe the sweat, and I'll keep one in my pack to keep dry if need be. So I've got my cap, I've got my two buffs. I will be taking sunglasses. They don't recommend that for just standard kit. But if there's a heat, you have basically two types, which says in here, which we'll go on to further on. But you have a heat kit and a cold kit. So you don't need these as compulsory, but I will be taking my sunglasses. And what else is there? They also recommend you taking two gels and two energy bars. Well, I'm going to be taking a lot more than that because I'm going to be running with Tailwind. And I will take a couple of gels, but I will eat as I go. So my Tailwind will be my main source of energy. I'll pour one of those in every flask. Keep one clean water and one with Tailwind, and that works really well. Try and do one of these an hour if I can, and then see where I go with that. But also then stopping at aid station, eating some of the food. The last mountain race I did, the Maxi Race, Salomon, the aid stations were pretty poor compared to some of the UK runs I've done, so I'm not expecting much. But anyway, we'll see how we go. I'm also gonna take my salt tablets. They're the most important thing now. I always will recommend is take some salt. I'll start taking salt tomorrow, and I'll make sure that I just keep taking those during the race. That stops the cramps. It basically locks in your water and your body. Really, really essential, salt tabs. So got those. What else have we got? That is pretty much everything on day one on that. Now, what they do is if there's a heat wave, hot weather, they say you need a heat kit, which is sunglasses, Saharan cap, which I've obviously got for my MDS, and cream and water reserve of 2 litres. Right, I've had a text from them already that came in yesterday saying you do not need a heat kit, and it also says you do not need a cold kit. The cold kit is protective glasses, a third layer, warm layer, and they like a fleece or an actual puffer jacket, and then some rugged and closed trail shoes. So, I mean, yeah, you're going to be running with trail shoes anyway. However, there's other stuff you should take, and which I'll just show you what I've got going on at the moment. So they're basically, I'm going to be looking after my feet. Had really bad blisters from the North Downs Way 100. So my feet, I'm going to tape my feet with a Hapla tape, and I'm going to take some of my spray, which I put on first, which gets the tape sticky. So I'll do that. I'll obviously take my pen knife. Now these bits I won't be putting in my bag, obviously. They'll just be prior to the race. Anti-chafe stuff. Squirrel's nut butter, I use that now, that's really good. Put loads of that on before the race. And I'll also put my foot cream on, and that should sort my feet out, fingers crossed. I also take some ibuprofen gel, and I rub that on the inside of my knee before the race. I don't know if it does anything, but anyway, even if it's a placebo effect, I'll do that. I get a sore inflammation, well, not really inflammation, but tendonitis or in the medial joint there, and it gets a little bit sore, and it's been playing up since the North Downs 100, so I'll do that. Sun cream, essential. Tingle out's great. I've got a smaller pot somewhere, but I'll probably take that with me. Well, I will take that one with me, and that will go. Will it go in my bag? No, it won't. I'll put it on, cover myself with that. That should be plenty for the day. So that's that. Loo roll. Always take your loo roll with you. You never know what's gonna happen. So I won't take a whole roll, but I'll wrap it into sheets of three. One, two, three, and then roll and take quite a bit of that and put that in a bag. Keep that nice and dry. So that's the loo roll. Right, what else have we got going on here? I think that's getting close. Right, yes, poles. They recommend you taking poles. I will be running with poles most of the time. The elevation on this race is over 6,000 meters. This is a mountain race, right? It's a different level of race. This is my second mountain race, so I'm pretty nervous about it. It's 100K, and last time I did a mountain race, I was out for 30 hours. Fortunately, this isn't as long, and I should finish it in about 19 hours, and so I'm not as scared about it, but there's some big climbs, and I got dizzy last time, so I've got to conquer that fear, and I don't know why I got dizzy, whether I was overwhelmed, whether it was altitude, whether it was just tiredness, I'm not sure, but poles are really essential because they guide you up the hills, and then when you're going downhill, they do help. People don't recommend you having them for downhill. You should take the straps off, so when you're going downhill, always release the straps there in case you do fall, and then you can just let go of them. So I've got my poles as well. So that's all good. I think that's everything. So what am I going to wear? Feet upwards. I've got my Hockers, my Maffetti Evos. They've got twos out now, but these are the ones I race with. They're brilliant. I've done about 300 miles in them. Already worn down the soles. So if I see Hocker out there, I'm going to have a chat with them. Take my toe socks. There we go. My Injinji socks. Take those. That'll be good. And then I've got my pants, briefs. I wear just my Ron Hill shorts, 20 quid pair of shorts. These are great, really comfortable, not too low, not too high cut. Arm sleeves, awesome. I'll take these. And in the morning, we start at 9 o'clock actually, so it's probably not going to be too cold, but it depends on the weather. I'll take those with me, and they keep you just definitely at night time. I'll put those on, and I'm going to run with my Innovate top. So I'm going to go Innovate all the way. Innovate top, that's just a normal short sleeve top. Hats, what have I got? There, I've done my hat, so that's about it really. There's no drop bag during the race, but there's a drop bag at the end. So when I finish in Chamonix, and I will get my drop bag. So they give you a bag. Where is it? They give you a bag when you're there. So what I'm going to have in that, I'm going to get a towel because there's showers afterwards. Where I'm staying is a friend's house further up the valley. So I'll probably get a shower straight away, depending on how I feel. Take a towel. That'll be my drop bag. Recovery calf sleeves, compression ones, I'll take those. Pair of shorts, take those, nice and comfy. I'll put a pair of boxer shorts in and stuff like that. I'll also take some compression thigh tights. These are compressed sport ones, they're really good. So I'll wear those pretty much straight away. I've got a little rollerball just to massage the legs, and I'll take my stretching strap as well. All of those will go in there. And there'll probably be a few little goodies in there, things like that, a bit of food and some nice things. But I'll work that out over the next couple of days. So that's the drop bag. So you get that once you finish. I think that's about it. That's all my kit I'm taking. I don't think I've forgotten anything. But I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be an amazing experience. And the whole vibe out there. I've never been to UTMB week. It's meant to be packed, just full of runners. So yeah, it's something I've been training for years. I saw a magazine, I mean the story, the background, if you're interested, is years and years ago, probably about 4 or 5 years ago, there was a magazine, my mate gave me a trail running magazine, and it had this picture of people climbing these mountains in Chamonix. I was like, wow, what is that? And I looked at it, UTMB, and I thought, that is something I've got to do. And here I am. So it's a really big moment for me, and I'm really super excited. So yeah, let's see how I get on.